This video and hundreds more like it available on freephotoshopvideotutorials.com. Okay, now I'd like to go into the topic of aligning. This is a topic that usually gets brushed over and we don't delve into much. So I want to take this video to show specifically what it is that we can do with aligning. So let's have a look here. If you open up our layers, we have technically seven layers here. We have six images. We have three portrait images, beach, pickup, and construction, and three landscape ones, farm lights and snowboard. I labeled these here with the little P and the L just to help us along. What I'm going to do right now is just show you aligning the portrait images. So we're going to unview the landscape ones. Now what I want to do is just move the beach and the construction images over. So I'm just going to drag them over here. There's the beach one and the construction one. And I'm not paying particular attention to how aligned these things are. I'm just moving them about. Now, if you were to select all the three layers, now we see that if we are on the Move tool right here, we have our aligning options, right? So the first option that we need to look here on the left is how these images align. I mean, you get pretty much a lot of clues with the way that these little icons are drawn. So as you can see, you have two little images here, one that is taller than the other, but they're just as wide, which is about the case of this one. And so what we're doing here is we're aligning these images that are not of the same height to the top through their center or through the bottom. So here the images are the same height, so we're going to get the same end result whichever one we click on. But usually, just as a form of a habit, you're usually aligning things vertically. So let's just click on that, and you see that now we have the top, the center, and the bottom aligned here because they are the same height. If not, you know, you could just, you know, see which one here works best for you. Now, the other option that we have is to have equal space in between these images here. As you can see, you have less space here than you do here. So the one to look for here is this one here. Now, with this little icon, you can see that what you're doing here, and the name will also help you along, it says distribute left edges. So it looks at the left edge of the image and the left edge of this image and the left of this image. So it calculates the distance from here to here, from here to here, and make sure that those two distances are the same. So if you do that, there we are, we have an equal distance from there. Now, because these are not exactly the same width, then we're going to have a little bit of a differing end result here, because if we click through the distribute horizontal centers, then it's looking at the center of the image and the center of this image and calculating that distance. So if we click on that, you see that this image moves slightly because now we're aligning from the center. And in the same way, if we go to the right, we're aligning from the right to the right. So there we are. But like I said, usually through the center is what you're going to be looking for. So that's one way to align things. And let's look at the landscape ones here. And let's use what we've just learned, right? So we're just going to move the farm one here and the snowboard one there. Okay. Now we're going to select all three layers. And I want to make sure I'm aligned through the center. And again, this one is a different height. So as you can see, we move that to the top or to the bottom, right? I'll put it through the center. And we'll align that space through the center here as well. So there we are. But now if you notice, we have actually less space here on the edge of the paper than we do on the left edge of the paper. What if we wanted to correct that? What if we wanted to make this, you know, let's say you wanted to print and frame this and you wanted this in the center, right? This is, you know, not looking too well. So what we need to do then is group these three layers. So we're just going to do Control and G to group them. Now we're going to select the group that we've just made. I'm just going to call them landscape. We're going to select with Shift the background layer as well. So we have the landscape group and the background layer, right? This white sheet. And now we're going to click on this one here, which is align horizontal centers. When we click on that, our image moves so that we have an equal amount of space from here to here, right? Now what happens if we wanted to move the snowboard one? We don't want this much space, right? So what we can do is we move the snowboard one right here, and then we can select the three layers, distribute them, and then select the landscape group, select the background, because as we can see, we have more space now here to the right than we have to the left. Select the two, the group and the layer, and select align horizontal centers. And there we are. We have things aligned through the center, right? Now, what if we wanted to actually add a caption to an image? I want to put here a big text that says farm. So let's see how aligning that goes. So I'm going to select the farm layer here, select the text tool, and click here and type in farm, for example. I'm going to put in a big size here, change my color to blue, and I'm actually going to make it a little bit bigger. I'm just going to do a Control T for free transform, just make it a little bit bigger here. There we are. Okay, now what if I wanted to align this farm text here within the image? Well, we can select the farm text and the layer, right? And now we do pretty much the same thing. We align here through the horizontal centers and here through the vertical centers. So there we are. We've aligned our image. It's perfectly through the center of this image. Okay, now let's do an experiment here. What if I wanted to then, again, change the distance here of the snowboarder so that we are changing the distance between the images? If we do the same thing we did before, right, which was move the snowboarder, let's say we want to make it really close like that. We're going to select all the layers we have, right, and then we're going to do distribute horizontal centers. Now, what happens when we do that? Well, we have the farm layer being its own layer, as if it were its own image. And what's happening here is that Photoshop is just trying to align everything through a horizontal center. So there's the distance between the center of this image and the center of this text here is the same as the distance through the center of this image and so forth. So this isn't the result that we wanted, right? So I'm just going to undo this. And what we need to do to correct this is if we have some text on a layer like this and we still want to be doing, you know, our aligning, then we need to group the two layers. So we select the farm and the farm image. We do a Control G again. And now we have that group, right? Which I'll name farm group. Okay. Now we can go ahead and select the group and the two images and do distribute horizontal centers. And there we are. We've distributed the distance in space here from the images. And we haven't messed around with the farm text and the image at all. Now, again, let's just center the landscape here. There we are. And we have a perfectly aligned image. And finally, for those of you actually using Photoshop CS2 or 3, right, the newer versions of Photoshop, you would have actually been able to recognize something. Now, if I move the lights layer here, for example, you're seeing that we have a little pink guide that is helping us along aligning things. And this is something that is called smart guides. And we can do smart guides by going to show, view, show, and smart guides right here. So if we have it unticked, then you'll be, you know, as older versions of Photoshop or the version that you have at the moment, right? But one of the key features of CS2 and up is this smart guides. And the smart guides allows you to visually align things without actually having to resort to, you know, selecting layers and then using the aligning tools. I mean, they're pretty good, but when you can do them just visually very quickly, then it sort of helps, you know, go along so you don't have to be changing tools or clicking or thinking about which button to press. But for example, it's very quick to align all your images, you know, to the left. Now, if you wanted to distribute the space in between these, then obviously we select our images, distribute the space. But if it's just a matter of just, you know, want to line up to all these images next to each other, for example, it just helps us along to do it much quicker, right? If we're not having to press any buttons, just aligning things. So that is a good tip there if you're using Photoshop CS2 or 3. If not, you can always do, you know, pretty much everything here, just a little bit slower, but with the aligning tools right there. If you enjoyed this video, show your support by subscribing, rating, and adding it to favorites. Leave comments on our website and we'll create even more videos that interest you.